It's funny sometimes how we get stuck into just loving a subject, loving to talk about a certain thing. We just get glued on. There was a season in my life where I just wanted to talk about essential oils all the time. I discovered them, discovered they were our new medicine cabinet for our family. And so any girlfriend that would listen, I'm trying to talk her ear off about the essential oils. And I think that women especially can be like that. They just find their little thing, and boy, they can be a great salesperson for the next newest, greatest product or whatever. So how about you girls? What would someone maybe close to you say, you are always talking about this subject?
I'm always talking about my kids and just the sweetest things that they're doing.
Yeah.
Me too. I love talking about my grandkids, my son, my family, my dog, Bernie, and the latest diet fad, I think.
Oh, yeah.
I love music, so just new songs that are out, new genres or styles. I love talking about that.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I'm a huge foodie. Like, if there's a new restaurant and it's really good, great customer service, I'm telling everybody. Like,
yeah. That's so good.
I would say TV shows. I'm single, so I watch a lot of Netflix.
So good. Yes, I mean, we want to tell everybody, right? When we're excited about something, we've got it on our minds. We are ready to share with whoever wants to listen. Here's my new diet. Here's my favorite restaurant. Here's my new show. Let me tell you what my dog did. Let me tell you what my kid did. Let me tell you about this new product. We just want everybody to know. And guess what? This week, our last week, week four, we're talking about our calling as believers to go fish, not to get fish to eat, but we're talking about the metaphor of going fishing for the lost souls that Jesus came and died for, because he doesn't want anybody to perish. His heart is so huge. I think you're going to sense and feel my passion, but even more so as you do the study this week. And the passion I just know comes because this is the Father's heart. He means business. He loved us so much that he gave it all. And so his calling is our calling. We're called to go fish. And so it's just something to consider, because when we follow him and we've got our mind on him, he's going to put our mind on people that need to know him, the people we see around us. Jesus told the disciples, he said, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teach them to obey everything that I have commanded you. So the question I want us to think about, and I want you to ask, why should you share the gospel?
No, I think it all goes down to whether or not we believe the gospel. You know, if we believe that it's true and we believe that but for what Jesus did on the cross, we were all separated from him, eternally destined to be away from him, then we can't help but share it, you know. We should be compelled, not out of rote obligation, but out of a passion that blooms from the transformation that we have had in our life.
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's interesting that you say that about the whole obligation thing, because I grew up in church, and it was just something that I felt I had to do. My mom told me, wake up, get dressed, let's go. But it wasn't until I experienced his love and his presence for myself and started seeking after him that I felt his love, and I knew him for myself. And he's good. Like, there's nobody like him. And now, why wouldn't I want to share that?
I love that you shared that, because this is what Peter was trying to get into our hearts. It's what he was preaching that we see written in Acts chapter 4, that he said, salvation is found in no one else. There is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved. We've got to remember that Jesus didn't save us so that we can just live our lives, go our merry way, and do whatever we please. He gave us his great mission, his mission to go out and reach the lost. And if Jesus's mission was to seek and save the lost, then this is our mission too. So how should we go? I believe there's two simple things that we need to keep in mind. The first is that we need to go in boldness. Paul said it so well in Romans 1. He said, I am not ashamed of the gospel because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes. I meet so many believers who I know don't feel prepared, but they really are. But what holds them back is that they're just afraid for one reason or another. What would you say holds you back from sharing the gospel sometimes?
I think just worrying about what people think of me or think that I think of them. I don't want them to feel like I'm judging them or anything like that. So that kind of holds me back sometimes.
So true. I know I don't want to be the know-it-all. Like I have all the answers. Yeah.
For me, it's definitely fear. It's fear that they'll ask me a question about something in the Bible and I don't have the answer, or I can't recite a scripture that they need, but I do know what God has done in my life, the transformation that he's done in my life, and he knows exactly what that person needs to hear. And once I realized that, once I realized that I didn't need to be able to recite every verse in the Bible, I was able to really start being able to share with people just what he's done in my life.
Yeah, for me, it's fear of rejection and then fear of the unknown. Like, what are they going to say? Like, what is their response going to be? So,
absolutely. I get nervous, too, and I'm overanalyzing about the right approach. Mm-hmm. Like, it has to be at the right time, and I'm always like, is this the right time? Is this not the right time? I don't want to move in too soon to bring up something, and I just overanalyze, and the opportunity's gone. Mm-hmm. And the thing we have to remember is we are not called to hide our faith. Like Peter tells us in 1 Peter 3, that we are prepared to give an answer to people when they want to know the reason. A lot of times they already know you're a believer. They want to know the reason for your hope that you have. So this is the second way that we are going to go. We're going to go in readiness. We're going to be prepared to give the answer for why we believe, why we follow Jesus. And Peter goes on to say, but we're going to do this with gentleness and respect. Even though we're bold, we're gentle, we're respectful, we're not steamrollers. He says, keeping a clear conscience so that those who speak maliciously against your good behavior in Christ may be ashamed of their slander. Your good behavior. This means that you're ready with an answer and you're ready with a lifestyle that reflects Jesus. You don't want to be sharing your faith if you're living just like the world, right? Mm-hmm. We are already, should already look set apart and look a little bit like Jesus before we say, okay, I'm going to go share the gospel, mm-hmm. right? How do you feel like you're prepared to share your faith?
I think the best tool that we have in order to tell other peoples about Jesus is to tell what he's done in our own personal life. Psalms 107 in the Message says, all of you set free by God, tell the world. Mm-hmm. Tell how he's delivered you from darkness and set your feet on solid ground. And that's it. We just tell what Jesus has done for us.
Mm-hmm. It's that simple.
One thing that I do that I feel helps a lot is before I even leave the house in the morning, I just pray, like, God, help me with conversations. Like, thank you for that, and thank him for the opportunities throughout the day, like, to just lead me and to listen to his Holy Spirit and be alert. I think a lot of times, like, I can just get really busy and not even look for those opportunities to share. And I noticed a huge difference when I do that. It could be one conversation or several just from setting the tone at the beginning of the day. So
I've got to expound on that because we do that, don't we? Busyness sometimes keeps us from sharing the gospel, you know, and I don't want to get to heaven and say, Lord, I was too busy. I'm sorry. But we do.
Yeah. Those are all really great points. Now I want to hear about ways that you have actually shared your faith. Give us an example of that.
Inviting people to church. That's really easy. I mean, our church, every week we have Pastor Craig delivering a message of evangelism and inviting people to Christ. Mm-hmm. So just inviting them to church.
Social media is a really great way, like Facebook posts, putting a scripture or two up there. It's good.
I love that.
I was older when I gave my life to Christ, and I had lived a life full of chaos and addiction. And I remember someone sharing the love of Christ with me who had that same background and how powerful it was. And so sometimes I go into places where I know women are who have that same background. And to say, I know how you feel, but Jesus loves you. And I found that to be an effective way.
That's great.
I think for me, you know, I stay home all day with my babies. And so really my mission field is so near where I live, but even just opening up our doors and allowing the neighborhood kids to come in and their parents to come in and just spend time with us. There are many opportunities to share truth by the way that we're living, just by opening ourselves up to people and choosing to be hospitable the way that the Lord calls us to.
That's great.
I like that.
Uh-huh. I serve at Church Online, and it has been a really cool way to share my faith with people all over the world, people who end up there on accident when in reality they're there because God directed them there, and they end up staying and they end up hearing, they hear the message and they come back week after week. And it's been such a cool tool to reach people all around the world that you would never be able to interact with otherwise.
That's right. Ladies, this is what it is all about. We are called to go fish. I love what the Apostle Paul shares in Romans chapter 10. We really see his heart. We really see his passion for the lost when we see his words, his questioning. How then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? How can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can anyone preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Girls, let's have beautiful feet. Let's go share the good news of Jesus. Let's go fish. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we love you so much. We're so amazed and thankful for the salvation that we have because of Christ Jesus. Father, I pray that we would every single day be prayerful, be ready, be bold, be ready to share your love, your good news, that you've come to seek and save the lost, that you've come to set the captives free. Father, may we be prepared to explain, prepared by the way we live, to show everyone, to be your light, that you are salvation, you are freedom, the way, the truth, and the life. We thank you that you prepare us, that you make us ready, that you give us the words, that you will do this. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.